Hello, I'm François Barrault, as you can hear with my lovely French accent. I'm French, very pleased to be here. And I'm here to talk about Sandbox and my life. I don't like career because I prefer to talk about life than career because it's more human. I start to work on technology in 1977. I was 16. And instead of having a motorbike, because I have a passion for music, I had a computer to create sounds. So that's how I discover the computing. And I start to work on a computer. It was machine language. It was 1 + 1 = 2 is about 60 lines. So now it's much easier. Then I discover AI in 1982. So I start to work on AI. And my first patterns, by the way, were done on robotics. I built, during my 2 years at École des Mines de Paris, I built a robot to analyze and help hemiplegic people to be re-educated. It took roughly 3 days to do the calculation. Now it's less than 10 milliseconds. So you can see the difference. I also learned quantum as early as 1980, quantum physics. And when I met Jack Hilary, I think it was 18 years ago, he and I hired him in my board. I was CEO of BT at this point. And immediately we connect because we have the same passion for technology and what we call in France tech for good. Technology is always aimed to give a better life to people. And when Jack called me, he was the first person who said, you know, you like AI, François, I love it. You like quantum, I love it. The first person, what do you think about AI plus quantum? And say, wow, that's great. Never thought about that. I thought about many things. So after 1 minute of discussion, I say, I'm in. So I'm very pleased, you know, to be part of the team, helping the team also to grow and also helping Jack and his management team, you know, to do the right thing. So if I want to reflect what's going on in technology, there's 3 pillars. The first one is hardware, sensors, camera, edge computing, big computer, storage. The second pillar is communication. And the third pillar is algorithm that will make the data relevant. When I look at the first pillar, technology, now, between now and 2030, some technology will grow between 10 and 1 million. So it's absolutely a revolution, which never happens. The second pillar, which is communication, with a fiber, with a satellite constellation, and with the next generation of high-frequency 5G, the latency will be divided by 100. My mission in life, I have two. Part of my professional life was to connect through internet. I built, during 5 years of my life, most of the internet network in life. So connecting people, bringing knowledge, you know, which I did in India or Africa or in China, the first mobile. Every time I could connect the knowledge to people, I was happy. And connect the people, connect the right part of the brain. And when the right part of the brain is connected together, then the left part of the brain, you know, follows. So I think it has been for me a fantastic journey, being able to meet people. The second thing also, which I really built my life, when I had decision to take, I never go in my comfort zone. One of the reasons is I grew up in a very old French family who was very happy to be the elite, but never want to change. So I was not happy with that. So every time I had to take a decision, I say, what is the toughest area I need to go because I'm going to suffer, I'm going to cry, but I'm going to learn. I'm going to be better and stronger. So think about that. Try to have a 360 view of your life. The planet is small, you know, especially between smart and young people. And when you have a decision to be taken, don't go scrolling your iPhone and eating donuts. Try to discover the world and try to suffer. No pain, no gain. What I really like with Sandbox is we are in a journey. We move from fundamental research to applied research, and now we are in business research. Every day, we learn something new. Every day, by talking to researchers, industry leaders, going to Davos, going to meet the scientists. Every time, every morning, we have new ideas. The problem we have lots of ideas, so how do we catalyze our energy? So the future is bright. I think the combination of AI and quantum, and I will always thank Jack, because Jack introduced me to this concept to bring. And you know, I was, when I said, of course, because I was very involved in AI at a young age and quantum, but I never connect the dots. So Jack, in 1 minute, I say, I'm in, because I immediately, instantly saw the benefits and the field we are going to build together. So if you want to have fun, if you want to build the world of tomorrow, if you want to be part of a fantastic journey, you know, take your keyboard, send the resume and join us. You will have lots of fun moving forward. Thank you.